bit interactive at the end. We'll hand over playbooks for you to play around with for some time, and then we'll kickstart the Q&A. Is that okay?
Yeah, cool.
Sure. Great.
Thanks, Abhis, and hi, good afternoon, everyone. So, Abhis kind of set the tone by saying, we make a presentation to you, to all of you, on RIM. And I know you're itching to get to your hands, get your hands on the playbook and know more about the playbook. So I said, okay, I'll make a small brief presentation about RIM over the tablet market. I came here this morning and he didn't set up the laptop. So are you okay if I talk through it or?
Yeah.
What if I just change it around a little bit? What if I present of the paper? Is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So why don't we do that? So these guys are fully using that. I don't need to carry my laptop wherever I go. So I'm based out of Mumbai, but the job requires all of us to travel frequently. So I used to lug around my laptop for presentations like this or meeting customers and carrying around your presentation. Now I just carry this and I carry my phone. That's it. And I'm connected wherever I go. So I don't need to really lug around my laptop anywhere I go. The beauty of it. So I just lug this in. So you can get it. So here you go. This is my PowerPoint presentation working off my desk. I don't need to walk around with my laptop. That's the beauty of it. Quick snapshot, if I want to have notes, obviously won't put notes on the first slide, but I have that option of even putting this in. Works great. I want to go into scrolling some slides, I have that option. So everything that you normally do on your PowerPoint on your off your laptop, you can now do it off this virtual laptop. So what the company, Research in Motion is a Canadian company, like most of you will be knowing, but this is more just to provide you an overview about us. We are headquartered in Canada, and obviously,
We are headquartered in Canada, but of course, operations plan the globe currently. And our model worldwide is we sell to our carrier partners, distributor partners. So currently, we cover over 175 countries. So wherever you go with your BlackBerry device, and now with your playbook, you can actually get connected in your BlackBerry device to over 595 carriers, I would call them carriers in these locations and departments, in about 175 countries. So virtually, I would say the globe is there for you to get connected on a BlackBerry device. And in terms of absolute numbers, for those who are interested, it's over 100 million devices sold today. Elaborating what I just talked about from a footprint, global footprint perspective, every country marked in blue on this slide is actually where we have a physical presence in the form of either direct or through the carrier partners or distributor partners. So if I pinch, drag and talk about India, which I won't do on my laptop, but I can do it here. If I talk about India, typically in India right now we have close to 9 carrier partners at the moment. And these 9 carrier partners are the top leading ones, as one would know. And and we have distribution partners as well. So to sell BlackBerry devices, to support it, we actually have the carrier partners here, these 9 months. What about the tablet market itself? Why are we so bullish on the tablet market? And what do we see? So these are not our data points, these are not our statistics. What we're really seeing is what analysts are saying, and we're trying to align that through interactions with people like you. Do you feel the same? Do you interact with the user community in a similar manner to get this feedback? We are very bullish because we've gone by what analysts say and what our customers and consumers have been saying. The bar in the gray and yellow is actually what represents a smartphone and the tablet market. The black and the gray one is the desktops and the notebook market. This year, as per analysts, most analysts predict that this year, which is 2011, is the year where actually the tablet plus smartphone market, in terms of absolute numbers, in terms of shipments, will actually cross the notebook and desktop market. So we're seeing this as a trend. Of course, these are global numbers, but that's something that makes us even more bullish about the way we have poisoned this market, being one of the leaders in the smartphone side and now focusing a lot on the tablet side as well. So where does the tablet typically fit in here? It's important to know because most of us are obviously familiar with the laptop and the smartphone, but there are a lot of questions that users, both on the consumer or the corporate side, ask us, and where does the tablet typically fit in? So you look at the left and look at the smartphone side. It's a device which you always carry wherever you are, so it has to be pocketable. It has to be always on, connected to the carrier network. It should have a great battery life, logically, because that's the very purpose and intent of it. You should be able to use it for both personal and business needs, whether it's email and corporate stuff or on the personal side as well for music, etc. But what's key is that it gives you a simplified user experience, and increasingly most device manufacturers, including us, obviously focus on a simplified user experience that comes. The tablet, and especially the BlackBerry Playbook, looks at this simplified user experience but makes it far richer. And we'll, as we go into the details of the product and the Kanjan and update, we'll elaborate a lot on the user experience of what we offer on the Playbook. But what's key, and I won't go into the laptop detail because all of us are familiar with that, but what's key is that the positioning of the tablet is important both from a personal user perspective and the business user perspective. So if I just dive into, say, the personal user, what does a typical user of today on the consumer side look at a tablet? What does he expect out of it? He obviously expects good high-speed browsing capabilities. He wants to have his email and social networking available to him on this, on the personal side, be connected with his friends, listen to music, reading of books, watching movies, playing games. Everything that you can think of on the personal side that all of us possibly do on a day-to-day basis is something that you come to expect a tablet to have. So as we dive into the product features and the specifications and some of the demos that we have for you today, you'll see how we fit the bill for each one of these requirements that the typical consumer of today has or requires. On the business side, we're getting these sound bites being one of the leaders on the enterprise side in terms of smartphones. We're seeing the same customers say, okay, you know, does your tablet provide you a video provide us a video conferencing capability or feature? Can we do our own collaboration tools or deploy our own collaboration tools? Can we do document and content management on the fly of the Playbook? What about, you know, applications around business objects or business intelligence tools, executive dashboards? If this is in the hand of my CEO or CFO, can you have a quick snapshot view of the overall dashboard of the sales forecast for the day or whatever? So we'll do a few demos as well as we go along, specifically on what we have from the dashboarding perspective, and you can obviously elaborate a little more on that as well on the app side and the vertical specific apps. So without further ado, I'd just like to invite Ranjan and Adwait to talk about the new BlackBerry Playbook.
Thank you, Sunil. So good afternoon, everyone. I also would just like to open my So like Vargas and Sunil already mentioned, between Ranjan and myself, we take care of product management for the first of all, it is pretty heartening to see a lot of playbooks around the table, and some playbooks being put to good use over there also. In terms of specs, you guys are pretty familiar with the specs of the playbook. 1 gigahertz dual core processor, 7 inch IOS screen, some speakers, 2 cameras. If you want further specifics, I just opened my notes page. I'm sure you guys have all the dimension, weight, display sizes, etc. One thing which we'd like to share is the BlackBerry tablet operating system is new, in case you guys don't already know. It is based on acquisition which Spring made some time back on QNX, and our entire OS has been created around it, and the playbook is on that particular operating system. In terms of size, portability, ease of use, a lot of you are already carrying it and know the benefits are the same. One key feature or highlight of the playbook is not only can you multitask, but you can also simultaneously multi-process applications or execute certain functions. So Ranjan over here would demonstrate to you guys how you could simultaneously be running apps and also process them.
Thank you. So what I'm doing right now is I have 3 different applications open. So I've got the browser, and that's actually a full flash-enabled site. And it does. I've got it minimized now, and what I've done is I've got a pictures app open as well, so I can take a look at my pictures. At the same time, I have a full high definition video playing in the background. So I'm talking 1080 pixels of full high definition playing, and if you notice, all these are running simultaneously. There's no latency if I want to switch back and forth.
And a cool way to switch between applications that are running in the background is you swipe from the side, like this way, and you actually don't need to come back and then switch back.
Hello, you guys, on your own try opening multiple windows. What is the maximum you guys have been able to do without any visible delay?
Eight. 8, 10.
Anyone gone further than 8, 10?
Yeah, I got 12 of 13.
Okay, great. Well, I know people who've gone up to 22 and they did not see any lag. So it's pretty strong, and which actually to do with the memory, the processor, and the OS. So not only simultaneously multitask, but multi-processing is pretty awesome on the table. In terms of browsing experience, for Flash, HeroWare, HTML5. And Quentin here is going to show you a couple of demos on browser, and then Sachit will take us through.
So one of the key things about the browser is not something that what we call as a mobile browser on a tablet. What we at Vim call this browser to be is a browser that gives you uncompromised browsing experience, that gives you the same experience as that of a browser that you have on your laptop or your desktop. So what that means is, most of us today, on the browser, you know, on your laptop, your PC, be it social networking sites, be it, you know, video streaming sites like YouTube or whatnot, you tend to use it for different purposes. And most of these sites are Flash-enabled. Just to give you an idea, this is a Flash-enabled site. And as you can see, it moves through smoothly. All each of these components are Flash-enabled objects, and I can view them seamlessly. There's no latency in the way Flash moves. Right? Now, if I want to take a look at a snapshot of Dhaka and football players right there, I just click there and say I want to watch the video. So I connect back to the video on YouTube, and it starts playing.
So a similar thing is there, the BlackBerry Facebook page is online, and right from the browser you can invoke a video. At the bottom there's a Facebook chat client open. So what we're trying to highlight here is open the browser and you get the true web experience,
yeah.
Uncompromised, which you can see.
So today, if you go into a social network site like Facebook, and you want to set examples, some of them play the games that are available on Facebook, like Farmville, CityVille, and those sort of games. So you can play that from your browser, open up Facebook, do the Facebook chat, play the Facebook games, and it just works.
Very good device for media consumption. Got a rich, high-res screen. Got your speakers. Awesome browsing. Videos. And why don't we show one of the videos?
Yeah. So this is the video that you have.